This is what I do when I comfort you. I'm a eat that ass like when I used to eat glue.
Might let your boy show for me, but he gotta eat the booty like groceries, but he gotta get rid of these hoes for me.
Bruh.
Alright, hey guys, yeah, Madea once again, Bundy girl inside. If you wanna know where you find me, we join live by with Kurt, you know, the wolf himself. If you're seeing this,
what's
on
going
YouTube,
on? It's been a while, but Madea, same way.
Bundy girl inside.
No way.
Boop boop clad. My bridging no tune. Yeah, if you're watching this on YouTube, that means you've been missing out on our live stream. We've been streaming certain gameplay on Twitch. So games like, let's say, Drive Club, Arkham Knight, the other things that are probably a bit too big to put on YouTube, we've been doing that on our Twitch. So if you don't know, our Twitch link will be in the description below. It is Squad TV. Like, what else could it fucking be? But yeah, it's Squad TV. So don't forget to go on there, follow us on Twitch, so you get to know whenever we're going to or go live with some streaming. So yeah, Kurt. Today we'll be playing episode 2 of Life is Strange. Haven't finished
at the
editing.
End of episode 1, you remember, guys, she told her friend everything that was gonna happen, so I guess in this one we're gonna try to prevent it, find her friend's girlfriend.
Hopefully I have a confession to make at the recording of this gameplay footage. I haven't even finished editing episode 1 because I've been a bit busy with school and other videos and projects. Let's talk about that real quick. I have to say a shout out to Anorak Productions. We're a part of the team. If you need anything, let's say photography service or video services, you can check us out. So yeah, that squad. Shout out.
You're saying we have the link.
Services.
Just ask us to get the link.
Shout out to Drifters, you know, Mugs was a success. Look out for the second Mugs, you know, coming August. And then shout out to the Strictly team, you know, Strictly Addies, the day of this recording, and I heard that Strictly Bubbling will be soon. So without further ado, let us go straight into some gameplay. Girls Dorm, let us begin.
Which mic are you using, Khalid?
Huh?
Which mic are you using?
Right now you're hearing me through my laptop mic, but I'm recording with the other one.
Okay.
In the previous episode of Life is Strange.
Oh my god.
Whoa.
Yes, what the?
What the fuck?
But he could be talking about photography.
Or have you done speech. Something wrong?
Shout out to Shia.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Matt?
To freeze you?
I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
You look fine from my side still.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
Leave him alone!
Actually, Max, I think you're right.
Chloe?
Nah, freeze, boy,
that makes perfect sense. I'd see you today.
Welcome home, Max.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
6 months
ago,
she just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me. Something happened to her.
Wait! Is that grass? Tell me the truth. That's an order.
I didn't black out. I had another vision.
Wait, look a bit up.
The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Max, tell me everything.
No, it's still freeze.
As in the webcam froze for you?
As in at the scene where she fell out, where she just got shot.
Oh, Jono. Alright. This is the thing about, you know, what we do, guys. technical difficulties and whatnot. What the f... Come on, Kurt. Come on. Yo, that's not cool, bro.
Mistake.
Fuck it. You see now, right?
Snooze, yeah.
Alright, way up. But then your girlfriend also may lay up, daddy. I love the music in these games. Don't Nod Entertainment. Shout out to Don't Nod. It's nearly for cleaner. Your room is a reflection of your vagina, ladies. You get what I'm saying? You feel me, Kurt?
It's stuck a square in the galley.
Come on, dog. You got to be kidding me right now.
You're a such.
But I'm looking on my computer and it says. I'm seeing shit. What are you using? Are you using your phone or your laptop?
Using my laptop.
Yeah, do that. Fuck Ultrabooks, by the way. We don't play that Ultrabook shit.
Yo,
yeah.
There's a game more to be tried.
Alright.
I am so wrecked after staying up all night. I could use my rewind to catch a few more Z's, but
yes,
maybe I better
strength.
Save my strength.
Girl, freaking using our powers to get more sleep. That's trouble right there.
No amount of rewind will keep
yes.
you clean. I still need a shower.
Make the bed.
I am so not a rebel.
Yeah, suppose
I always like my bed to be neat and tidy. Thanks, Mom. The Max Caulfield
no,
Photo Memorial Wall.
Well, shit. I got a bail mask. What? Yo, this girl talk too fast. Oh my god. How bitches think so fast? 40 million sorrels, yeah, I got it. Or what have they been texting about? You there, hippie, what about that fucking snow? Great power. I need your help.
You know, kind of share your screen.
Alright, I'll do that instead. So. Shout out to Skype. Alright. Start. Yeah, see?
Yeah.
Alright, yeah, shout out to Skype. You know, fucking changing, you know, making life easy and shit. I need to scale this so it can be seen properly. Alright, supposed to be almost there. This is a lot of thing goes on in the background that you guys don't know about, you know. Like a lot. It takes hard work to produce these videos and we're so glad that you always stay around to, you know, watch them. So we'll have to say thanks. So let's continue.
This can work.
Alright. Alright, so she told us to meet her at the diner in 40. Let's see what me and okay, there hasn't really been any text messages.
Even with all this crazy shit going on, it is so cool having Chloe back in my life.
You ain't got no ass.
Whoa.
No.
Hello, zombie face. This
quantum
is what
physics.
Happens when you research quantum physics.
Yo, that shit gave me hell.
Just because some ass pranked a girl's shampoo bottle and her hair fell out, we have to safeguard our toiletries.
That's
so
true.
Summer camp.
I remember when I was in living that dorm life, you know, a guy peed in this other guy's shampoo bottle because he left it in the shower all the time. Funny shit.
Good morning, Kaz. I hope you slept well.
He's really in the streets.
Would man rape all them selfie portraits?
It's serious, you know, dog. Like, big man thing in my head. Like, some. Like,
now
some
I have
shit.
To wonder
like,
if
I remember
any
one day, like,
on the true story.
Well, the guy beside of me, or actually in front of me, he was like, yo, let's go surfing. I'm like, surfing weird.
It's got electrolytes.
Outside. And he's like, right here. I like, the grease up the floor and went freaking surfing on the mattress. And the worst thing about it is, like, we didn't use our mattress. We used some dude's mattress. He left his room door open, and we took his fucking mattress. And we were, like, sliding all over the hall with it.
It would be fun to get some peeps together and play a real game instead
college life.
Of drama games.
Pretty cool, though. The thing about it is,
Cartier
I want to get
Bresson,
trophies,
Bruneau,
so
Hamilton,
I'm trying to go through.
The greatest.
Because they get trophies for taking pictures.
That's the only tourist picture I let them take of me at the Space Needle. I could rewind for days and read all of these books.
Alright, so
really
see what's going on here, Kurt?
My power?
It would appear that she has started to abuse her power.
I can't keep my eyes open, but I know there's
Sorry,
a scientific surgeon? Answer.
Yeah, it looks so. Take a selfie.
No smiling. Take your power seriously.
Watch out. She feels she cute. Come on, trophy. More trophy? Really?
This picture will capture this crazy historic moment in my life.
Right.
Warren is blowing up my inbox now. As long as he helps me figure this out. This is so insane, it sounds logical to me. This wormhole thing makes total sense, but doesn't explain how I can be with no science. I would say this is some crazy shit, but now I'm not so certain. And I thought I was into Halloween. Dana is not messing around here.
Fucking show her. Let's go.
Okay, Max. Let's hit the showers.
No, she'll have timetable.
Mrs. Hoyda is still out sick. I heard somebody say she has severe depression. Poor thing.
Whoa, there's a class called Life Drawing. Like, really, what are you giving these kids in school? These days, like really a class called Life Drawing.
Didn't have that stuff back in my day. It was always art and craft.
Don't forget I need those
yeah,
before
get...
tonight. Like now.
Some simple
Thanks,
shit.
Sherry. Yeah, of course, Victoria. I'll get the tests and papers to you this afternoon. I am so on it. Consider it done.
Let's talk to Victoria. Hey, girlfriend.
Fine, I won't disturb you. Fine, I won't disturb you.
Oh, look, Kurt, it's a fat bitch.
Ow!
Girl gets hit in the head.
Alyssa, can you stand over there?
Okay, Max, if that makes you happy.
Yeah. Second time.
Thank you, Max. Wow, now that was close.
Save your bitch ass.
Thank you, Max.
Your fucking fat ass. Yo, Kurt, you ever been fat fished?
No.
Oh, funny shit, I tell you. Funny shit. I'm guessing you can probably tell what I mean by fat fished. It's the same as being catfished, but she's...
With a fat chick?
Yeah, that's right. She's fat.
Whatever they're watching must be hot stuff.
Hello, Juliet.
Hey, Max. Did you check out Kate's hot video yet?
Why should I?
Because it's fucking hilarious.
Why should I?
Because it's fucking hilarious. Church girl gone wild.
Really? Kate's not like that and you know it.
Really? Check her out and tell me what she's like.
Do you believe everything you see?
That's why I like being a male. It's touché. Less drama.
Now I feel like an ass.
Less drama.
Thanks for finding out the
proof
yesterday.
Remember 2 days ago. Fuck it.
Are you sure? I thought you'd be pissed. Not at you. Part of me was almost disappointed because I built up so much rage.
Glad to see you're back in action.
You have a good one, Max. And I won't watch Kate's video anymore. Or pass it on.
That's the spirit.
Thanks, boo.
Thanks, Juliet.
I think Juliet is probably the best
looking girl
to all of them.
There's Brooke looking smarter than everybody. Hey, Brooke.
Oh,
hi,
Max.
Did you see the snow? Yeah,
did you see the freak snowfall yesterday?
I was riveted by that weird snow flurry yesterday.
I can't tell if you're being serious or not. Since I'm a science noob, I was wondering if you could explain it.
I'm serious. Even meteorologists can't explain that snow. I bet Warren can. Did you talk to him yet?
I will later.
Lucky you. I'm sure he'll track you down, Max. I'll see you around.
Why would Warren or a meteorologist go through?
I don't know.
Wake up, Max. Juliet is next to me in
the
hall,
wait,
not
up.
In the room.
Psh. Fucking noob. But she happy, E? Fear life nice, E?
This is both sad and pathetic.
Trevor's jacket.
Trevor is making himself comfortable. Hope they don't get busted.
Contraceptive pills. Young lady, come here. What have you been doing?
Hi, Dana. How are you?
Much better than yesterday. I'm glad we talked.
Me too. I know it's good to just talk about this stuff.
You're almost psychic. I felt like you knew everything anyway. By the way, the best and biggest news of the day is that Trevor asked me to the Halloween shindig.
That's awesome, Dana.
At least we're showing our faces together in public. So you absolutely should go with us. Borrow one of my outfits and come as a cute geek couple with your bitch Warren.
I'm not big on cosplay.
Don't let life pass you
Kurt,
by, Max.
Kurt, are we going to the party or not?
Are you coming to the party or not?
Sure, why not?
Yeah, break up.
Why the fuck not? If I hate it, I can always go back to my room.
That's the spirit, Max. After this, you'll be ready for a rave.
It does sound like fun. Now I have to go contemplate my party.
Contraceptive pills, what the fuck? Fucking whore.
Speaking of Halloween, look at all this makeup. At least Dana knows how to use it.
Oh my god. Whose room is this?
Taylor is no doubt being led around by Victoria, as usual.
I forgot to greet everybody and tell them morning.
Sleeping. Clearly
what's
not
right
a morning
here?
Person. Samuel truly is a weirdo. But
yeah.
He is great at cleaning
weirdo.
Up.
Weirdo. Alright, let's go scrub our vaginas. How the hell is she right here, so? Wasn't she in her room like a while ago?
Hey, Kate. I'm here. How are you doing?
Oh, someone else.
I'm here. Thanks again for standing up for me yesterday. I needed that.
Anytime. That guy has issues.
No.
Isn't everybody here?
Got issues, bitch.
By the way, Max, do you still have my copy of the October Country? Oh, yes, of course. It's great so far. I didn't realize Bradbury was such a poet. Can you please bring it back to my room this morning? I just need to take some notes for class. Absolutely. I'll bring it by later.
She's such a fucking nerd. Brush your teeth first, bitch. Yo, what else? So she not brush her teeth? Okay. Oh, oh, she's hot.
Okay, the trees again. Oh, there, nice one.
Oh, yeah, baby, work it. Wait, is she like 12 or something? Kurt, how could you, you pedophile?
What?
Fucking saying that the bitch is hot, but she's like fucking 12.
I'm not hearing you, bruh.
And fuck you.
What's up, Kate?
School. That's it. That video of you clubbing didn't look like homework.
Victoria, that wasn't me.
Oh my god, right. Don't be shy. I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
Oh, boo-hoo. I'm sorry you're a viral slut. I'm sure she had fun.
Looks like it.
I know Nathan hooked her up. And you know he has the good shit.
Reach it, sister.
Yup, I still have goddamn paint all over my face. Good thing my faithful minions took their sweet time bringing me a towel.
We ran all the way.
Give it a rest, Taylor. Now I know if I'm in an accident, I won't rely on you or Courtney for help. You can hang out with Kate.
Yeah, we can go to this fuck her up.
Unfortunately, not.
She's a weirdo with that dumb camera.
I hate that I'm so quirky crap. Anyway, let's leave the link to Kate's video so everybody gets a chance to see her in action.
You are such an evil biatch. I love it.
This girl's got no ass. Girl look like fucking matches stick to blood club.
Matches stick off shit, but I can't talk about it.
Alright, well, she look like a tooth. So she not a giraffe. Yo, this bitch probably have fucking, what's the name of that infection? Yeast. Not drying off her shit.
I better get dressed and go give back Kate's book. Water is almost as good as a cup of strong tea when I'm in sleepy mode.
The fucking...
Water is almost as good as a cup of strong tea when I'm in sleepy mode.
Hello? Water?
Sorry. I forgot. Is that the link to Kate's video? Damn, Victoria is so fucking mean. Even if I can stop one person from watching it, it's worth it. Oops. I forgot about the water pressure.
Rachel is a whore.
Rewind.
Really? For what?
No, I was happy on them last minute.
Oh, you're right. Fuck. You smart, nigga. Alright. I completely forgot I had the port here this time.
Even if I can stop one person.
What? No, I can't wash my hands. Can I shower again? No. Can I go in the shower? No. Guess I'll just leave. Let's go talk to Kate.
Fine, I won't disturb you.
You don't want to disturb nobody. Yo, who drew that on my friggin' door? The let's go get ready for the day, Kurt.
Maybe I'll just put on a shirt and jeans. Hey, Einstein had the same exact suit for every day of the week, and he couldn't even rewind time.
So I can't do nothing?
Doesn't look so.
It looks like I just gotta leave. Such a fucking nerd.
Hold up, I need to find the book before going to see Kate. And nothing here. Of course she just spilled soda on Kate's book. I better fix this fast. Kate needs the book, and I don't want to add to her list of problems. Be gone, foul soft drink. Aha, you sneaky book. You're mine.
Oh, wait!
Now I can finally take this back to Kate before I'm late. As if I have to worry about being late anymore. I do have all the time in the world now.
You're supposed to say bless you, Kurt. Yo! I just remember something, dog.
Go on.
The last time we did this, you remember the problem I had? Keep your smart mouth shut. I'm coming for your ass. I know where you sleep. Yeah, the last time I recorded was that the volume was too low.
Shit. Now I'm getting anonymous threats. Right. It never ends. This has to be from Nathan. But it could be anybody.
Alright, before I go through this door,
careful around here, or I could be in serious danger.
Right?
If I'm way not
up. Stay up. My girlfriend house and my lay up. And then I am going to stop this broadcast. Alright, could you please speak for me? Keep talking, don't stop talking.
I think I'm done. I'm gonna chat a lot, but anyways, this is what I do when I comfort you. I'm a eat that ass like when I used to eat glue.
Bruh. Wait. Hold the fuck up, dog. Did you just say you're going to eat the glass like how you eat glue? What the fuck, dog? Learning process. Yeah, we're good now. We're good. We're going to completely forget about that little clip that you guys just heard about a certain someone eat certain things like glue, shall we?
Freddy? No need to go there now.
Kid? Yeah.
The marks of Satan. Kate? You in there?
Yes, I'm here. Come in, Max.
Kate is all alone dealing with this video bullshit. I hope her mother doesn't disown her. Kate used to play the violin every morning. She stopped last week.
Is, bro, fucking up lives out there. It's a journal I saw.
Why did she cover up the mirror? She can't look at herself?
Yo, this girl have some fucking deep issues.
Kate's art is perfect for a children's book. Everything looks so fun and colorful and positive.
Tell her, bro, she got some deep issues. Didn't even make her head.
Kate really has a doting father. That's a lot of tears. She's going to go through boxes. I had no idea that Kate ever hung out with Alyssa and Stella.
Learn something new every day. Trophy. Give me a trophy. Trophy? Hey, trophy.
That is the cutest bunny ever. I bet Kate is a good mommy.
She'd be a good mommy.
Ouch. She left out Amnation.
No spirit or evil could have done in that videotape. And like a Jezebel released your harlot image before God's eyes. I will pray with your church, with my church, for your soul to be saved from eternal hellfire. Auntie Marsh. Wow, yo, that's some deep shit. Seen his skirt?
That's fuck up.
Auntie? Come on, bro.
Good lord. This must be Kate's H.R. Geiger period.
Real fucking giant flames on fire. Let burn.
Kate's room is usually immaculate. For her, this must be a pigsty. Maybe Kate has a split personality. Church girl by day, party monster by night.
What did that leaflet say?
Maybe Kate.
No matter how much you like each other, one slip up can change your life. You have a choice. There's nothing wrong with. Yes, use a condom every time.
Maybe Kate has a split personality.
Yo, boy, you know, when she want to get that shit wrong, you know, you do that shit wrong, nigga. Yo.
My parents never once took me to church. I had nothing to rebel against. I don't know what to believe now.
Chicken in it.
Damn, it's the all-American zombie family.
Yo, Kurt, talk again.
What the fuck is that? I mean, what are them look alike? Is this some incest shit?
Probably Amish? Who knows?
I've seen Amish people. Well, I've seen like legit real Amish people 1 year, dog. Like the girl, they look picking their barefoot, dog. I was like, shit. Barefoot in the dog, that's what
I almost forgot what Kate looks like when she smiles. Poor Kate. She doesn't look good.
Hey, Kate, I brought your book. Max, why did you step in between David and me yesterday?
I hate bullies. David Madsen should know better.
I was hoping he would. But it's nice to see that you care about me.
Kate, I actually do care. So, what's the story with you and David?
Well, he's a total paranoid ass. He thinks I'm part of the Vortex Club. Yeah, right.
Did you party with them?
I went to a Vortex Club party against my better judgment. Not my scene at all. You know how humiliating this is for me?
I know this sucks, Kate, but tell me about the video and maybe I can help.
Basically, I went to one Vortex Club party. and ended up making out with a bunch of people.
Wow.
And I have no memory of it.
It doesn't sound like you. I can't see you partying with Victoria.
I didn't.
You have to tell me more than that. What happened at the party? Did you drink?
I swear to God, I had one sip of red wine, and then I drank water.
Not enough to get wasted, is it?
I don't get wasted. Ever. I take a sip at church, and I don't end up on a viral video, okay?
Did somebody drug you?
I remember...
Oh, they drugged her.
I remember getting sick and dizzy.
Go on.
Then Nathan Prescott said he would take me to the hospital.
Just connect.
Nathan Prescott?
Remember, he's selling drugs?
He was being nice for a change when he offered to help me.
He's the opposite of nice. What next?
All I recall is driving for a long time. Then I woke up in a room. I thought it was a hospital because it was so white and bright.
Go on.
Try rape you.
I'm listening.
Somebody was talking to me in a soft voice. I thought it was a doctor until I heard Nathan and felt a sharp sting in my neck. And? That's all I remember. I don't know what happened. I woke up outside my dorm room the next day. I didn't have any marks or bruises, but I felt gross.
So, who took the video of you at the party?
I have no idea.
Jenna,
probably Victoria. She was there being her mean self.
Jesus, Kate. I'm sorry.
This Jenna is Star.
How do I get a viral
video? She got fucked in the ass.
I know it's already spreading. What if my church Young sees that?
Dog.
I need to know what to do.
Kate, we'll figure it out. I'll check back later, okay?
Shit.
Thanks, Max. You can put my book here near my bag.
There's something inside our bag. A bit. Oh my God. Oh my God.
So Max, can I ask you a question? And please be honest.
Absolutely, Kate. Anything.
I need to find out if Nathan Prescott helped me or hurt me after that party. Should I go to the police?
What would Shia do? What would Jesus do? Kurt, what would you do?
The logical answer is get proof, then go to the police. Okay, if you go to the police and memorize a Prescott,
yeah, like
team family
would,
reach
yeah,
out to
you. Yeah,
so
yeah. Right, nigga, you right. Smart.
If you do that, they won't believe you. You're on video grabbing at all those guys, and they'll use that against you. Bad.
But I know I was drugged.
That's what you have to prove, not them. I'm just telling you how the cops in school will look at this. The video doesn't exactly back you up.
You make me feel so hopeless.
No, Kate. I just don't want you to get hurt anymore.
That seems impossible at this point. So that's your answer?
I think we should wait. There are other things going on that might help you.
But not right now. So I can walk down the halls with people calling me a viral slut. Thanks, Max.
Unappreciative. Oh my God.
Good job, Dr. Max. She didn't like what I had to say, but we need more proof of what happened.
Yeah, great going, Dr. Phil. I swear I just saw something. Can I open the windows? Sun shining! Let me slide it inside. And look, it's the weird old gardener.
The paint job looks great. Samuel knows his color schemes. The birds are flocking around Samuel. Ah, there's Samuel, up early. Already. Hey, Samuel. You're up early.
Max. Oh, hello, young Max. I do love you.
A pervert.
Everything is so calm and quiet. And I can feel the animals waking up with me.
That's one thing I truly love about Arcadia Bay. It's all those cool animals in the forest.
The squirrels always come in the morning for food. I can hear them whisper. What animals do you see in the forest?
Don't laugh, but I saw a doe that seemed to be looking right at me. Like it was trying to communicate.
Oh, that's your spirit animal. Nothing weird there, except you saw yours. Could be a sign about your destiny. What do I know? My spirit animal is a squirrel.
So, what did you think about that freak snow shower yesterday?
Another message from the Earth to get our shit together. I will say that Samuel hasn't seen anything like that before.
I so don't want to get in the way of your morning ritual. See you later.
Of course you will.
I remember what I said, Kurt. Go around taking pictures, getting trophies. Those games that I can plan on. So
one no football zone.
Try to go around and find pictures.
How hard is it to dump the trash into a bin?
Release the Kraken. Come on, squirrels. Time for your 15 minutes of fame.
You hear squirrel?
Squirrel.
Squirrel, squirrel. I know you want that nut. That nut.
These nut.
Yes. Another Pulitzer for the portfolio.
I got my troll.
I've never seen Samuel wearing shades. And what's with this other crap?
Boy. A playboy partner.
Sometimes they gotta just choke that chicken.
I play with this thing again. Samuel really should keep this locked. It's a waiting accident. And too easy to sneak into. I don't think I've actually seen Taylor alone without...
Hi, Taylor.
Hi, Taylor. Just because you were nice to Victoria doesn't mean I have to be nice to you.
Mean girls.
I don't want to fight with you or Victoria. Instead of smack talk, let's just talk. For once.
You're funny. Well, I'm not doing anything at the moment, so talk.
Kate is really upset about the video. All this gossip is cruel.
Boo-hoo. That's what happens when you preach to everybody about sex. She'll live.
Fucking bitch.
Why do you hang out with Victoria? She's pretty mean to you and Courtney.
And she's bossy, too. Look, you don't know her. I do. And she's one of the best friends you could have.
I guess I've had mean, bossy best friends, too. Better than having mean, bossy parents.
I would love it if my mom was mean or bossy instead of sick. But whatever. We've had our talk.
So I can rewind some.
Hi, Taylor.
Hi.
I've heard that your mother was sick. I'm so sorry. What happened to her?
Well, if you do care, my mom had back surgery. Victoria was there for me. Like you are for Kate. I'm not about tearing people down, Max.
I know. That's why I wanted to talk.
I'm...
Using time travel to my advantage. You go, Max.
The Prescott dormitory? Good lord.
Yo, this nigga stalking me.
My dorm?
Warren's out and about already too. Looks like he's waiting, Warren. What are you doing here?
Well, Warren, take off his beard. What do you expect?
For a call? I mean, I already took the call. Anyway, I wanted to rap about that action yesterday.
By the way, thank you for stepping in. You were pretty badass, Warren. I owe you.
Oh, yes, you do. I got knocked on my ass by that dick. I'm some personal superhero.
You're a real everyday hero. You stood up to a bully, and it was awesome.
Even though you left me with said bully and ran off with that girl, she's pretty punk rock. How do you know her?
An old friend, Chloe Price. We haven't seen each other in a while.
I bet you were glad to see her blast up in that truck like a rock star. Which begs the question, why is Nathan Prescott getting psycho on you?
Should I tell him? Should I? Don't know. Or it's better to keep him in the dark. That's true.
I busted him in the bathroom yesterday with a gun. I was too scared to tell Principal Wells. Please, don't say anything. I'll give you more info later.
You're fucking weak. Like that bizarro...
Let him just completely ignore the fact that he has a gun.
Dystopia, that drive-in is having a 70s Planet of the Apes marathon. Let's go ape!
Can I rewind? No. Should we go? Should we... Well, I owe him for punching him in the face. Or getting punched in the face. Alright, Zara, we'll drop the pussy upon him.
Yes, that's exactly what I need. I love those old school ape films.
Well, that was easier than I thought. Cool, I'll text you the info.
But don't I have the dance as well?
What fucking dance? Oh, the Halloween shit.
Yeah.
Warren.
Oh, nothing. Waiting.
Brett.
Oh, yes.
You're a real...
Even though you left... I bet...
He's dangerous. I don't want you to get involved. You got me there, but lay low. Nathan Prescott is going to get his karma soon.
Really?
Weird fucking week.
But I said never mattered.
Like that bizarro snowfall yesterday? Speaking of dystopia... Well, that was...
David talking to Nathan cannot be a good thing. This has something to do with Kate or Rachel.
Oh, it's a cool kid. So cool. Wow. We're going on a trip, a very special trip through the skies. Little Einstein, whoop, 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 taking the bus, whoop. Good times, Kurt. Good times.
Round, round and round, round and round. Feel the lava soon, round and round, all through the day.
The wheels on the go round up, round up. Round it. Cast some light and be alright. This music is just depressing, son. Come on, son. I just saw Taco Bell. Dressing ass music. I bet you're going to do something like skip school.
I'm gonna look for Chloe, most likely.
And the cool kid is still on the bus. Swear?
Talk about going back.
So I can't cross the road.
The diner looks exactly the same.
Yep. I'm ready to cash my
luck. I bet he's seen a lot of changes to Arcadia Bay in his lifetime. She looks busy and stressed.
I wouldn't dream of it.
Be a millionaire, hope you would steal my luck.
Oh my god. It's a dog.
Stop that. Stop. No barking.
There's that dirty RV.
From this the manos, but they are bright. You know, manos. An RV dirty. Clean your room, girl. You need to clean your ass room.
Look at all these flyers. It's so sad that nobody will read them.
Yes, let's save the bay. Since we're all going to die in like the next few weeks.
Good morning. Looks like you're ready to catch some serious fish.
I wish, young gal. Arcadia Bay just isn't the same fishing town I grew up in.
Has the town changed much?
By Neptune's beard. Seems like a lifetime ago when I was king of the harbor.
Young Justice.
You did pretty good.
You know, today I was watching that Batman movie, Animal Instinct.
Jump onto my boat.
I think I'm in love with DC animated movies.
Yeah, I like DC, but I don't know if I like that one. I don't know why.
The Prescott's have a lot of power.
They might rename the town Prescott Bay.
There's a part that 2 coming out.
The thing about it is, I like the fact that Nightwing was in there, and then Red Robin, and then you could see the prototype for the Batman Beyond suit. So I really appreciated the fan service.
Never forget that old fishermen never die. We just smell.
Yeah, part 2 coming out first.
I'd love to learn more, but I have to get going. Happy fishing out there.
There is a text message from
Chloe.
Yeah, baby, I love you. Right through me. It's paper.
I wonder if they explained that snow. Snow? Well, that's a good start to the story. Excuse me, sir?
Can you believe this town? The world is on fire, and our big headline is snow. I can hardly wait for next week's big story. Clouds!
The snow was pretty odd. It was right in the middle of a warm, sunny day.
Oh, global warming bullshit. It's the Northwest. Snow happens.
I keep reading how Arcadia Bay is booming.
The paper can only talk about that or about missing girls.
You mean Rachel Amber?
I guess. I bet she ran away because she was bored. Who wouldn't be here?
So I can't cross the road, but I can explore the place and talk to this homeless nigga.
Hello.
Oh, look at you. A fine example of youth. I bet you're a senior student.
Yes, I go to Blackwell Academy.
I could tell you're a wise young woman. I know all about Blackwell and this town.
Who's Joyce Price again? Oh, Joyce Price is what's her name, mother. Prescott's.
I bet you have dirt on the Prescott family.
That whole family is dirty. They once done good things for Arcadia Bay. Those days are dead, like anything in their way.
I know somebody who's being threatened by a press cart.
Then you be their guardian angel, because nothing gets in the way of that family, especially not the law. Hell, they own your school, Blackwell. Almost.
You must know Joyce Price from the Two Whales Diner.
She's fed me more than my own family. How's a daughter your age who's always in trouble? Married to a real prick.
His name is David Madsen.
He told me to get a job once, asshole. Not sure what Joyce sees in him, but he better treat her right.
How long have you lived in Arcadia Bay?
1,000 years. I've gone through the same changes as the town.
What changes to the town?
Ones it takes a lifetime to see. There's a lot of beauty here, but a lot of darkness, too. Greedy bastards that ruin this town, put people out of work. Out of home. Like me.
I'm sorry. Have you ever lived outside of here?
Where the hell would I go? I hate the sun and love the mist. I might be homeless, but Arcadia Bay is still my home.
I have to go now.
Bye, homeless lady. She gave me a lot of insight. You can't do that shit in Jamaica. Go flick your fucking lip. Fucking bums. Air police, fire truck, fire truck. Fire truck!
I don't want to go that way. Man, that smell of breakfast and the sound of clank. Now that brings back memories. Chloe and I loved the parade. These fishermen are so damn quiet. Did you catch any big ones today?
If by big you mean none, then sure. I caught a lot of big ones today. Now let me mourn.
Take a bright.
Hello there to you.
It must be Canadian, eh?
Oh yeah, it's gonna be a super day.
Enjoy your breakfast too, eh? He was such a nice lady. Man.
I bet that's the same gum from when I was here. This guy has serious cojones.
Oh my god, I want to sleep. Grown people are boring.
What's up, Justin?
Getting my coffee on before I cut class and destroy some rails. Shouldn't you be taking photos?
I am always taking photos. I am a camera.
You crack me up, Maxer. Of course I'm baked. So I'll laugh at anything.
You should be studying, bad boy.
So where's all your homework, schoolgirl?
School? Speaking of buds, I saw your bro Trevor sneaking out of Dana's room.
Trevor finally told me about him and Dana hooking up. He got there first, so I snooze and I lose. See you later, Max.
Hey, Trevor.
Holla, Max. By the way, I know you saw me in the dorm.
Yeah, I saw you coming out of Dana's room.
Yeah, and I finally had to tell Justin because, well, he was in there too.
How did Justin react?
I got him blazed. He was cool. Nobody has secrets in Blackwell anyway. See you in class, Max.
Yeah, see you, bro. Can I change music? Yeah.
I got you, babe. How apropos. But no fucking way.
Yeah, change that music. Cheat.
Forgot about the Fishing Wall of Fame. funny? Our family.
Oh my god.
Watching. Looks fun.
Rocco.
Burn.
Isn't everything in here within eyesight?
I don't care for your tone. You sound like Joyce.
How does Joyce sound?
Bossy and smartass. Like you.
Joyce rules. I want to be exactly like her when I grow up.
Looks like you're on your way. I've been coming to this dive for 3 years, and Joyce gives me shit like it's going out of style.
That's how she rolls. That's why I worship her every move.
Good. I can't wait to see you flipping greasy bacon in a diner when you grow up. Exactly like Joyce. Now pardon me while I get back to my coffee.
I don't feel like talking right now. I gotta deliver a load of breakfast to my stomach. Over now.
Hello, sir.
Hi, young lady. You look a little lost.
Just hungry and thinking about what to eat.
Now that is a real problem at the Two Wells. I can never decide. Joyce's pumpkin pie or grilled mac and cheese.
I guess you're friends with David Madsen.
I wouldn't use that word. We know each other. Why do you ask?
He kinda has a reputation at Blackwell.
I have respect for David. He served his country. He found his calling at Blackwell. At the station, we're happy David is exactly where he is. Not everybody can be a cop.
How well do you know Joyce?
I know her delicious grub. Everybody at the station comes here. We take care of this place like it's our own kitchen. And Joyce, like she's our...
Oh, bitch.
Our mother.
So, you know Chloe?
Sadly, we all know Chloe down at the station. Poor Joyce. Just heard that Chloe...
What? What? What?
Who told you that?
I didn't hear it on the police scanner. Joyce said the weed belonged to Chloe's friend, but I highly doubt that.
Joyce didn't tell you who?
She wouldn't. Afraid I'd go arrest somebody, as if I would. I'd just tell the loser to stay the hell away from Chloe, or else. Just kidding. Besides, David Madsen's watching over.
What?
Is she a friend of yours?
Not really.
That's good. She's not a bad person. She's had hard times, but there's no excuse for burning things.
I know her dad died.
My dad died when I was 13. I never burned garbage cans or tagged signs. Joyce is a great mother. Chloe just isn't paying attention.
I have to go now. Enjoy your breakfast.
By the way, one thing I can tell you for certain is to stay away from that RV outside.
I usually stay away from sketchy parked vehicles.
Wise policy. The guy who lives in it, Frank, is pretty sketchy himself. That's all I can say for now.
Wow. Wow. Now I'm a notorious weed.
And there she is. A lovely young woman. How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce. It's nice to see you again. You look the same.
Like I'm still a waitress at Two Whales after all these years.
No, like you still look pretty.
Nice save, kid. You're still smart. But not that smart. Now you get busted for smoking pot. I heard the whole sordid story from David. I'm sorry this was how you had to meet him. He's a good man.
Yeah, I'm sure. I don't even smoke, like, ever. It was almost an accident. Very stupid. I'm sorry.
It surprised me fierce. I was hoping you could be a good influence in her life now.
I will be. Promise. I know things were hard for you and Chloe. I feel bad I didn't call. Now my folks are in Seattle and I'm all alone at Blackwell. It's my karma.
You did the right thing. You moved forward with your life. I did after William passed on. Chloe chose to stay angry. Anyway, I hope we see more of you. Chloe needs an old friend again.
Joyce, I am so sorry.
Yo, man, when people talk about death, like, come on, bitch, move on.
That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories. Even if Chloe doesn't understand yet.
Chloe must have changed a lot during that time.
Oh, she hit all the phases. Expulsion, running away, drugs, bad boys, tattoos, piercings, blue hair. Now she's got to rebel against her stepfather.
I see why, I mean.
Do you? He's not as much of a hard ass as you think. But you did tell him you had a joint, right? You took that responsibility?
David scared me when he said he might have my scholarship taken away for that stupid joint.
Nobody's in trouble over a doobie, Max. And I admire that you took the heat for Chloe. Like a great friend. But Chloe does push David, and it's not fair.
Yo, stop.
He does.
She's a type of woman that if you box her, she'll tell us she'll love you afterwards.
He cares about Kate Marsh?
David mentioned her, but I stay out of his business. I won't patrol Blackwell, and he won't cook at the diner, you know?
I saw him arguing with Kate. I thought you might know why.
Nice try, Nancy Drew. But next to you, there's only one student I'm worried about. And she's not even in school anymore. So, now let's get down to the nitty-gritty. What do you want to eat?
Kurt, this is probably the biggest decision in my life. What should we get? Belgian waffle, bacon omelette.
Dude, bacon is life. Bacon is life.
Well, that's true. Bacon it is. I love me my meat.
I was dreaming about your bacon omelette.
Now finish your coffee. One bacon omelette for the young lady, stat.
Bacon at 12. The only thing that's changed on the menu are the prices. I hope nerd graffiti. Warren must have been here.
Can I get some beer and bacon before I die?
This is a diner, not a
This
bar.
Is like fourth dimensional deja vu. I keep going like back in time.
Stick with bacon.
The lighthouse looks so mysterious. I wish I could stay in this moment forever. I guess I actually can now.
What kind of dive is
but then it wouldn't be a moment.
Incoming!
I can hear your stomach rumbling from here, Max. Here, you'll love this.
I'm drooling like a baby.
Still can't believe you're a woman. When I look at pictures of Chloe, ugh. Speak of the devil.
Yeah, baby, my love, yo.
Mom and Max, together again.
And Chloe looking for a free meal. You put your whole damn college fund on your tab.
I'm treating Chloe for breakfast.
Are you atoning for yesterday?
Oh God, Mom, please do not give Max any shit for that. She apologized.
I know she did. Max is a good girl. Woman. She's 18 now.
Too old to get lectures from you or Sergeant Pepper.
Call him David if you don't want to be lectured. You only get one damn slice of bacon a day.
You guys are still the same.
Another reason to blow this town? What is this shit on the jukebox?
Yeah, baby, so that's a good stand up there.
Now that that's out of the way. Let's talk about your superpower.
I don't have any explanation, and I can't explain why I saw that crazy tornado.
Come on, that's such a daydream. I want proof you can rewind time.
I wonder if she touches her, if she can end up being rewinded in time as well.
I can tell you every single thing you have in your pockets.
You have X-ray vision, dude? I don't even know what's in my pockets. Let me see. Okay, Max. Impress me.
Have a gun.
Let's see. A gun?
I left it in the car. Wrong answer. Okay, psychic girl. Let me show you what's actually in my pockets.
Alright, what's that? What's that? What's that?
That was beyond epic fail. You even made me want to believe you.
Cigarettes.
Okay, Max. Study every item.
Alright, so this is a key. Car keys with a panda bear with a heart on it. Six coins, warning ticket, a parking ticket. Wine time.
So, this is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max, I'm hella ready.
I'm pretty sure you have cigarettes.
Yes,
oh my gosh.
So how many cigarettes?
I think it's seven.
Seven cigarettes.
A superpower that allows you to count cigarettes. Cool. Amazing. Something else in my pockets?
A parking ticket.
You know me well. But
Jesus Christ, dog. Huh?
Ten.
10:34 a.m.
Booyah! Max can tell time! Even a broken clock is right twice a day. Whatever the hell that means.
Your car keys.
Duh! Way too easy! I need details! Describe my keychain.
A cute robot panda keychain.
Not bad, Super Max. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield. What else?
Some money.
Clearly I'm rich as fuck. How much do I have?
I think it's about 82 cents.
82 cents.
I wish. Okay, psychic girl. Let me show you what's actually...
So I get the money part wrong, really?
So, this is...
Okay, Max. Duh! You do have that... Boop! Even a broken clock is...
Alright, it's not 86, it's not 82, it's 25. What?
25 cents.
You lose. Okay, psychic girl. Let me show you.
Is it?
Okay,
1 cent, 5 cents,
don't forget anything.
Quarter dollar. It's 86. $75. 6.86. Oh my god.
So this.
Okay, Max.
$0.86.
That's right, living large in Arcadia Bay. So that was cool. Show me more. Yeah. Your car.
Way to go for time leaps.
Booyah! Max can tell.
Amazeballs! I literally just got chills all over my neck.
Did she just say amazeballs?
You have powers.
I'll take that crap off the table, Chloe.
Sure, Mom.
How's the food, Max?
Better than I remembered.
Very good save.
Man, I'm hungry.
Somebody walking up to them.
Clearly. I'm freaking out about what just happened. You have to show me more. Something way cooler so I will believe you without any doubt. I will predict the future.
No way!
Now, pay attention to everything that happens in the next few moments so you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power.
Oops!
Did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. And now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
I'm going to predict four events that will happen in the next 30 seconds or so. The trucker drops his mug, and Joyce rips him a new one.
So, what happens next?
The cop gets an emergency...
Oh, that's wrong.
...and he quickly exits the diner.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
Justin and Trevor are fighting, and Joyce breaks it up.
Yes, you still need to tell me one more event, Max.
What?
Oops.
Dude, did you right. break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a
I think
don't
not,
slap
Max.
Me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finished.
Oh, that's right.
It's wild.
That's the best song I've
this
heard.
This is sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So, what are you waiting for?
Now I should rewind and tell Chloe everything that just happened. I'm going to predict. Justin and...
This is getting good. Can't wait to see what happens.
The jukebox goes crazy as the trucker tries to play a new song.
Pretty bizarro, Max.
Yeah, let's see.
But let's see if everything happens like you said.
Yo, Kurt, did you see the trucker thing about the jukebox?
Did you break
another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
I think not, Max.
Me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
That is wild.
A cockroach really crawled on the jukebox.
This is a sad day in Maxville.
This is sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So, what are you waiting for?
Now I should rewind and tell Chloe everything that just happened. I'm going...
So, what happens? Well, let's just...
Like stillborn, huh?
Cockroach. This is getting good.
The jukebox goes crazy as a cockroach crawls on.
Let's see.
Pretty bizarro, Max. But let's...
I hope I get it right.
Break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a
I think not,
slap
Max.
Me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
That is wild.
This is sure the hell better than that other garbage.
Is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So what are you waiting
for? So I never get it right. What?
Chloe, everything that just happened.
All right.
I'm going to predict. The trucker drops his...
So, what happens next?
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio, but he does nothing except eat a donut.
Well, let's just... This is getting good! Can't wait to see what happens!
The juke.
Pretty bizarro, Mac.
Next time I get this shit right.
Oops.
Dude, did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're
I think not,
slap
Max.
Me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
So I got the police thing wrong.
I'm going to predict.
So what happened?
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio and his partner in the car leaves without him.
Well, let's just see how... This is getting good. Can't wait to see what happens.
Oh, I think I got it right. No refill for you?
Did you break another cup?
Oh,
really?
Go, Mom.
No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You called it. He's off to go bust some skaters.
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Trevor and Justin must be in love. You predicted a cockroach on the jukebox? I pledge allegiance to Max and the power for which she stands.
This isn't a toy, Chloe. I do have to be careful how I use it.
Screw that! Of course it's a toy. The best toy ever? You can bang anyone with no strings attached, rewind time, and boom! It's like it never happened.
Grow up.
Maybe you made a move on me and I would never know.
Yes, that's what I did.
You can rewind time, Max. That's fucking insane. We have to play.
I don't have time.
You did not just say that. Check out your nose. Too much blow?
Hey, are you okay?
Too much excitement. See what happens when we hook up again?
Then, let's go to one of my secret lairs and fully test your power. You need a sidekick to guide you.
Okay, Girl Wonder. Show me the way to Chloe's cave. Chloe finally believes me. And I wonder what kind of crazy shit she has in mind now.
I think I'm ready for thirds.
But you're only on your first.
My stomach plans ahead.
Your stomach is stocking up for winter.
Coming up at noon, K-Bay 7 News will explore the mystery of yesterday's unusual snowfall on a warm and sunny late afternoon that confused and delighted Arcadia Bay residents. We'll be talking with Portland meteorologists in the area and look at some of your fun video reactions to the odd snow flurry. Who knows? Maybe Mother Nature was pranking us all. So, stay tuned to K-Bay 7 News for the real story.
That graffiti has been here forever.
Trophy. Very well, it would appear that Mr. Hammond is out cold, so I will be taking over. Silently, that is.
Okay, Supergirl, let's go to my secret place. Don't even answer. We have places to go and what we do. Come on, before Mom starts some more shit, let's bail.
It's Kate Marsh from Blackwell.
Big whoop. You don't call me once in 5 years and now you're all over some biatch you see every day at school? I see how you roll. So go ahead, chat up Kate Marsh from Blackwell. I've got other people to hang out with too.
Why they give me such a hard decision? Should I choose a new bitch that I probably won't get over the old bitch? Like, oh my god, these decisions are so hard. Oh my god, I think I need help. I don't know what. Oh my god. Eeny meeny miny mo, catch up eeny meeny miny mo, catch a nigger by the toe if you ever let him go. Wait, no, that's not right. I can remember this. Eeny meeny miny mo, catch a nigger by the toe if he hollers, let him go. I hope I don't regret this.
Later, Mom.
I really do.
Bye, Joyce.
Freedom!
I feel bad about Kate.
She'll survive you not taking that one call. Now follow me, young Squire Max, so we can seriously tap your power.
Now that I'm thinking about it, I'm going to rewind time. I'm going to see what happens if I answer that call. And then I am. I'll see what happens if I do answer the call.
Let's go to my.
Hey, Kate. What's up?
Please, don't let your best friend get in the way.
You okay? I promise, Kate. I won't forget. I swear. Just do your homework and don't stress. I really don't think we should go into this right now. I'll call you later, okay?
Thanks, Max. If you'd rather chill with Kate, please, go ahead.
You are ridiculous. I'm chilling with you, okay?
For now. Let's rock.
Sometimes it's good to leave people support, you know?
Sucks that Chloe and Joyce got into an argument. I could rewind and not answer Kate.
It's a nigga from the parking lot. I wonder what he's up to. Checking out all this fine ass. That's what he's up to. All this fine ass. Okay, I'll stop talking now. All by myself. Don't wanna be all by myself.
Is this a race?
Keep up.
How many times are you going to get pissed at me this week?
That depends on you and how well you do in this phase of the test. Welcome to American Rust, my home away from hell.
Raw and rough. It suits you.
Max, do you know how awesome this is? I get my best friend back, and she's also supersized.
We don't know for how long.
Exactly why it's time to have fun.
Are you kidding? After yesterday, I'm kind of over guns, Chloe. Freaks me out that you have one.
Don't you trust me?
Yes, but not that gun.
You have more power than an army. Don't be scared of my little toy. Besides, we need it for the test. Drink?
Yuck.
You are so cute. You haven't changed a bit. Okay, let's do this. Can you find 5 bottles while I prep the shooting range?
Beer and guns? Nice combo.
You can handle it. Now go find us 5 bottles, pretty please.
Hello, bottle number 1. 4 more to go. No way! I totally remember going there when I was a kid. I loved the Hush Puppies. Now the sign is just Arcadia Bay. Nope, I don't want to go there.
Break time.
Those shells look fresh. So disturbing to see old syringes on the ground. I could use this board as a bridge. Doesn't look too heavy. This looks like a graffiti museum for Chloe and Rachel. I can't see Chloe playing with makeup. That kind of hurts. They really were besties. That could have been me instead of Rachel. Rachel songs. I wonder if Chloe would ever make me a mixtape. Ouch.
bottles left.
I want to die. Jeez. Who wrote this? Now we're officially a trio. We just have to find Rachel. Aw, poor thing. They left you here all alone.
Like Kurt left me all alone? Fuck you, nigga. Fuck you mean.
Beyond repair. Rest in peace. So sad to look at a grounded boat. I wonder who owned that and where they are now. The Bigfoots were here. Way heavier than I thought. Ugh. Three down, two more to go. Talk about finding a bottle in a haystack. Although this junkyard is a dive, I see why Chloe hangs here. She's a steampunk. It actually feels like Chloe and I are kids again. We're hiding out and plotting our future. Despite all the chaos and bullshit, I feel so giddy hanging out with her again. So happy. Like we've both gone back in time. I'm sure this is a popular party pit. One more bottle to go. Thank you. Nope, I don't want to go there. Voila! Now I can deliver this bottle booty to Captain Chloe.
Thanks, Max. Wait, one more for the road?
You're serious about this?
We're gonna shoot all these bottles without wasting a single bullet. Max, you have to help me aim. Show me the way, Max.
I need to see you shoot first.
Show me the way, Max.
Aim a bit to the right.
Sir, yes, sir. Oh, yes! Did you see that shit, Max?
Duh.
That was so fucking cool! Now for the second bottle. Now, Max, where do I aim?
You're on target. Pull the trigger.
Now, Max, where do I
aim? Slightly above.
Right between the eyes. Watch out, Nathan. Now that is fun. Let's pump up the volume and find me another target. I want to get creative here. Give me something to shoot, Max.
Let's take out this wheel rim on your left.
Taking out the wheel rim now? Hella yes!
Nice shooting, Tex.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Satisfied?
Like ever? So I want one more uber cool trick shot.
How about using that junker for a target now?
Dude, I need a target before I shoot.
How about aiming for the left tire?
Adios, spinning wheel of death. Uber cool. I cannot believe this is for reals. My best friend is a superhero! Now it's your turn to bust a cap.
I don't know.
Max, your nose. Damn.
I don't feel so super.
Max! You freaked me out there. Do you feel any better now?
A little. Thanks for helping me. Just give me a minute.
Too much action for Arcadia?
Maybe not enough. This is kind of fun. Scary and stupid, but fun.
Let me know when you feel okay.
God, this power really messes with my head. I'm glad I feel normal again. I better go chat up Chloe.
Okay. Looks like you're ready to lock and load.
I don't know about this.
Are you afraid of getting in trouble?
Oh, boo-hoo. Max is afraid.
I know you can handle this. And I'm here to guide you. Make me proud, sister.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise. Or is it Bonnie and Clyde?
Excuse us, Frank.
Oh, sorry, Chloe. Don't let me get in the way of your bonding. I heard the gunshots and the breaking glass. It's cute that you're playing with guns. Just like me at your age.
We're not anything alike, man.
We both need money. In fact, you need it so bad, you owe me a shitload, don't you, Chloe? Huh?
You'll get your money.
Don't they all say that? You know, even when they're broke and acting tough? What are you hiding there, girly? Let me see.
Where did you get that bracelet?
A friend, and it's none of your goddamn business. You're my business now.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
No, it wasn't. You stole that shit. Give it to me right now, asshole.
You better step back before you regret it, girl. I mean it. You want me to cut you, bitch?
Please. Please step back.
You're kidding. Put that down.
Like, I can't right now. Like, they give me such hard choices. Should I not shoot? I don't want to shoot. I can't lose my scholarship. I'm not going to shoot. I'm sorry.
Come on, girly. Shoot me. Ah, Christ. You're more like Abbott and Costello. Nice piece. I'll consider this interest on your loan. Thanks. You have until Friday to pay me, or I'll track you down.
Real shit. Oh my god.
Have a good play, kids.
You really stood your ground.
I freaked. I don't like guns.
It'll be hard to keep Nathan off my ass. My step shit will have his other gun sealed in an electrified bunker by now.
Sorry, Chloe. I've never held a gun on a human being before.
Rewind!
Not cool.
I know, Max. Really. I'm actually relieved it worked out this way instead. And there are more guns out there. Let's blow. My secret lair didn't feel secret today. At least Frank is gone. He won't fuck with us again. He just wants his money.
Oh, man. Frank took Chloe's gun.
Rewind!
I wonder if Chloe thinks about her father when she looks at all these smashed up cars.
Oh, come on.
Exactly like the same dough from my tornado vision. So quiet and primordial out here. I always feel like the forest is whispering to me. Like Arcadia Bay is trying to tell me something. I just have to figure out the message. Hard to believe that was once on the road, filled with dozens of students.
Are you ready to do this?
We should jet before...
We have plenty of time to do anything we want, whenever we want. Make me...
That is hilarious. Oh, man. I'll remember you, kid. I'll remember you almost shot me. And you'll wish I had no memory, because I never forget. You have until Friday to pay me. Don't ever pull crap like this again. It'll be the last time you do. Try bullets next time, brainiacs.
Sorry.
You are awesome. Thanks for standing up for me. Let's blow. My secret lair didn't feel secret today. At least Frank is gone. He won't fuck with us again. He just wants his money.
Jesus, I almost shot this guy. And now he'll be more dangerous to Chloe and me.
Are you ready?
Come on.
Chloe's waiting to go for a walk.
Guns aren't safe, kids. Never use them.
I can't believe you basically gave him my gun. Here you go, Frank.
You can't keep getting mad at me. Especially.
Yeah, I swear this game is too mad. Best money I've ever spent in a while, but.
And I just liked having that gun, man.
Long daddy.
Now you have me to protect you.
I'm just glad you were here.
Me too. I think. Chloe, why the hell are you hanging around scary losers like Frank? It's weird.
Let's take a break and I'll talk.
Feels like a different world, huh? I wish we could stay forever.
Can we build another pirate fort and keep the world out?
We need a new secret hangout. At least Frank wouldn't find us. Are you okay, Max?
Seriously, Chloe, this is scary. What if Frank tries to track us down?
I'm sorry, but Frank isn't as hardcore as he fronts. All he cares about is his cash, stash, and mangy dog.
Chloe, are you for reals? Frank just took your gun and threatened us. He's armed and clearly dangerous.
Max, I know. Crazy shit is the new normal for me. That's why I plan to leave Arcadia Bay without paying Frank off.
Now, tell me exactly what's going on between you and Frank. Does he have a last name?
Frank Bowers, he's just a dealer, where I get my weed. The one in your joint, remember? Anyway, Frank and I kind of hung out.
Hung out? You don't mean you...
Oh, no, we didn't have sex. Gross, man. He never even tried. I just made the mistake of borrowing money so Rachel and I could bail out of here.
That's it?
No. I want to know how Frank got Rachel's bracelet. What do you think?
I think we have to be careful and keep an eye on this guy. Without him eyeballing us, okay?
It's so weird talking to you about this insane crap. We haven't hung out this much since we were tweens, and it's like no time has passed. I wish Rachel was here to meet you.
Do you think that Rachel and I would have been friends?
You're not that different. She had... has a great eye for images and for art. Plus, she's a smartass like you. We would all be hella best friends forever.
I know she must be as cool as you are. I have no doubt we'll meet soon.
Railroad tracks always make me feel better. I have no idea why.
Kerouac knew. It's the romance of travel and movement. The sound of the train whistle at night.
Look at the beat poet here.
I'd rather be a good photographer.
You are. You just have to stop being afraid.
Perfect. Out like a superhero. Move! I don't want to go that way.
Come on, Max! Hurry! Brain, get me out of here!
I can't even move it an inch. Awesome, it's not locked. I better find a tool to cut those wires.
The train's coming! Max, please! Max, get me out of here!
Shit, I can't budge it at all! I need to figure this out. I can definitely use this bad boy.
Max!
locking the draw. Which wire to cut?
The train's coming!
Now that's the right cable.
Max, get me out of here!
I don't know. This looks way... Damn! Something is blocking the draw. I can finally move the drum.
Get me out of here, Ryan!
I have to help lift Chloe up. In and out, no problem. In and out, no problem.
I need to figure this out. But which wire to cut? Now that's the right cable.
Come on, Max! Hurry!
Now I can finally move the drum.
Come on!
Damn! Something is blocking the drum.
Come on, Max! Come on, Max!
Now I can finally move the drum. Lift Chloe up.
Max!
Whoa, I seriously wrecked the switching lever. This should help me free Chloe, but I could have done it another way. Damn, that was close.
You saved me again.
You okay?
I got splinters in my ass and leg, so I wish there was a less violent way for you to save me. And now the trains can't get to the lumber mill. Oops. Aren't you glad I took you away to a nice, quiet, desolate spot?
It was cool to spend time in your lair, but I have to get back to school before my next class.
Since you're the mysterious superhero, I'll be your faithful chauffeur and companion.
My powers might not last, Chloe.
That's okay. We will. Forever.
Thanks for the ride, Chloe. Right on time for my art lesson.
Thanks for coming with me. Sorry to be so boring.
Nothing exciting ever happens to us, right?
Listen, your rewind power has to be connected to that snow yesterday. That might explain your tornado vision.
I don't see how. It's so friggin' random.
Wake up, Max. You saved my life twice now. You altered the course of my destiny, yours, and whoever. Do you know about chaos theory?
It means shit happens, right?
No, crazy shit happens. Because it can. And will.
Why me? I'm just a geek girl in some small town.
A perfect example of strange attractors? Don't they teach you kids anything at Blackwell? We have a tornado, rewind power, and freak snow. Hello, Armageddon. So let's party with your power, Rockstar!
Like you said, Professor Price, a superhero needs a sidekick.
How can it be such a shitty week and yet one of the best of my life?
Because we're back in action again. a little time before Mr. Jefferson's class, so I can do some wandering.
So are you going to that Vortex Club party?
Like I would miss it. I have the sweetest outfit.
Zachary always looks like he's ready to throw a football. Hello, Zach.
Sup, Max? It's weird to not see you without your camera.
I'm always taking pictures with my eyes.
I bet. As long as you don't talk to everybody about all that shit with the sext and Victoria.
I won't. That's what Victoria wanted.
Yeah. I noticed she kind of set up her own drama, even if it fucks her over. Weird.
She doesn't have to, though.
That's what I don't get at all. When she's hot, rich, talented, what more does she need? Anyway, see you at the game Friday, Max.
That snow was so insane.
Seriously. Hello, climate change.
Excuse me, Mr. Madsen?
I know things got a little heated yesterday in Chloe's room. Was that really your reefer?
Yes, it was. You know that marijuana is almost legal in Oregon. I can get it at Blackwell. Are you gonna bust me now, Mr. Madsen?
Even I'm not that much of an asshole. And I am sorry about yesterday. I was wrong, but upset. Cannabis is not a big deal to you, but it has been to Chloe.
You're a combat veteran. She's no threat to you.
If I didn't care about her, I wouldn't care at all. When I was her age, I was out raising a lot more hell. She's better than that. All you kids are. So is Kate Marsh.
But you treat Kate pretty bad.
You step between us at a pretty bad time. She's another matter entirely.
Kate hasn't done anything wrong.
Max, this isn't just about Kate Marsh. My concern is for the safety of all Blackwell students, including you.
That'll take more than surveillance cameras.
It will take more than Ms. Grant and her petition to find missing students.
Isn't that your responsibility as head of security? Unless you know something about Rachel Amber that nobody else does.
I don't want to fight with you anymore. I don't want to fight with anyone anymore. That's all, Max.
I saw Victoria and her friends shopping for the party.
That reminds me, I have to score some weed from Nathan.
Bring me the brain, Igor.
Think, big brain, think.
Hey, Warren. Are you okay? You look thoughtful yet confused.
Maxwell Silverhammer. Perfect timing. I need help with this chemical experiment.
Asking me for help means you're screwed.
I have to add either a bit of potassium or sodium. It's up to you to decide, Dr. Max.
I have a vision. Go Diem.
Godium? That's the worst pun I've ever heard. Yet Max has spoken. Sodium it is. Damn. Zip. Nothing. Nada.
Hey, Warren.
Maxwell's
asking me.
Have to add either.
I'm not sure why you're letting me decide your fate, but go potassium.
Potassium it shall be. If this works, you get a free hug. Weird science. Yes, I am a scientist. Fuck.
Bring me the brain.
Alright, the thing is, I know I'm supposed to take some pictures.
Bring me the brain, Igor. Bring me the brain, Igor.
Leave me anyway.
Stop acting so brittle.
I'm trying, but you have to understand my position.
Why? You don't understand mine.
Sorry to bother you, Mr. Jefferson.
I'm only bothered when you avoid turning in photos. But you know this. So what can I do for you, Max?
Just between you and me, I'm worried about Kate Marsh.
That's no secret. Word on the street is that you and Kate had a little confrontation with our security chief yesterday.
I stepped in between David Madsen barking all up in Kate's face about something. She doesn't deserve that.
Of course not. Mr. Madsen isn't the most gentle soul. Do you have proof he instigated the situation?
My word isn't good enough? The one time I choose not to take a picture.
Always take the shot. My number one rule of photography. And Max, I promise this matter is being discussed by the faculty. I assume you know about this viral video?
Kate is freaked out by all of this. She can't do homework while she's being tormented on a daily basis.
What if Kate brought this on herself? She means well, but maybe she doth protest too much. She seems like she's holding back the truth. Have you talked to her?
Yes, I talked to her on the phone today. She needs friends and support now. I just don't want Kate Marsh to become the next Rachel Amber.
Rachel Amber? What does she have to do with Kate?
With all her missing persons posters around, it's hard not to think of her.
Rachel was nothing like Kate. And Principal Wells said you had something on your mind you wouldn't tell him. You care to share?
Not right now. I'll tell you everything as soon as I figure it out.
I'd like to believe that, Max. It just seems like there's a lot of drama around you this week.
Listen, should I...
Excuse me, Max. Hello? Yes? Hold on. I have to take this, so just go into class and I'll be there soon.
Make me beautiful, Hayden. Vogue. Vogue. Vogue.
Do you think Max will be pissed with...
Here comes the mysterious Max, disguised as a pixie hipster.
Like all the other precious twee artists here.
You really nailed me.
Meow! Bring out the claws! I love seeing chicks fight.
Right. Can I sit at my table now?
Max thought we were going to be buds. Fucking ha ha.
Ow.
assholes. Yes, I am a scientist. Fuck.
Bring me the brain, Igor.
Here comes the
Okay, why is David taking photos of Kate? Now this is so wrong and weird.
What up, Max?
Hey, Warren.
I saw Kate earlier and her eyes were puffy from crying.
Kate has a lot on her plate.
I didn't know what to say and she didn't tell me anything.
Okay, I know you love me, but if you're not in this class, beat it. Everybody else, please sit
down.
Maybe I'll
see you
later. We have a lot to cover today and so little time as usual. I see all the usual suspects here. Anybody seen Kate Marsh?
I think everybody has seen Kate Marsh by now.
She's not feeling good.
Sounds like you're giggling about a video gone viral. Maybe it involves a student or a friend. I wonder how it would feel to have false images of yourself shot out all over the world for people to judge. Usually, people need something to judge so they never take a good look at themselves. We can thank reality TV for some of that. In the end, we can only blame ourselves for participating. Speaking of participation, there are a few souls here who have yet to enter a photo in the contest. Like Max Caulfield, for example, who I know can't wait to enter, right? I'm sure you read the syllabus like it was a Harry Potter book, so you must know today we're studying chiaroscuro. That beautiful word about the contrast between light and dark. The shadow play that gives photography such visual power. It's basic yin and yang. Black and white images are effective precisely because of their contrast. Although we don't technically see in mind.
Yo! Some crazy shit is going down in the girls' dorm!
Zachary, do not come into my class like that ever again. Listen, everybody remain seated. Dismissed.
Is this for real?
It flipped out.
I didn't think she was that messed up.
Should probably go and check what's going on. I really don't. Your blood claw.
Oh, no. Is that
not again?
Oh, not my again. God.
I have to try something. I won't be able to rewind again and again.
Oh, my God. Oh my God, the bitch killed herself.
Keep going, Max. You can do it.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, I can't believe it, yo. The hell is going on?
Yes.
Here, Max. Stop! Don't come near me!
Not now. It won't work. I don't have any power. Now I have to...
Oh my gosh.
Max, seriously, don't come near me. I will jump.
Okay, okay. I'm right here. Kate, please.
Oh, Max, I know you want to help me. I love that you stepped up to David, but it doesn't matter now. Nothing matters.
Don't worry, Kate.
Oh my gosh, I'm winging it.
I promise.
I do want to believe that.
Wow. Okay, I can rewind time, yo. What am I going to do, yo?
Let me help.
I'm glad to hear you worry about me. That makes me feel better.
Of course I worry. You're my friend, Kate.
I did feel better.
I might be lying right now, but I don't want her to kill herself.
I feel like you really listen.
Bitch, your life is mine.
Trust me. Come stand by me, okay? I can help you now. I know I can. This morning, I erased the web link to the video. It was written on the shower room mirror.
That's your story now. How can I trust you? What about this morning when I needed help? You told me to do nothing.
Kate, I'm gathering proof that Nathan Prescott drugged you. And you're not the only victim. So you have to help me take Nathan down.
Nathan Prescott? That makes sense. He's a scumbag. You have proof now?
Soon, then straight to the police.
Yeah, believe in me, bitch.
You're cleansing Blackwell.
You do have my back, Max. That's the first time I've felt hopeful in a week.
Good. We all need to have each other's backs. So, I want you to come with me now.
Please, you don't have to do this. Max, I'm in a nightmare and I can't wake up.
Ooh, that's
unless I put myself to sleep. Then everybody at Blackwell can post pics of my body. I'm horny on the internet forever. No wonder they call it a web. Nothing can ever get out.
Oh, this bitch fucked up.
I wish I could go back in time and erase everything.
I won't say, alright. I won't say that everyone will forget, because no one never forgets. I can say there are billions of videos like it. Like, all people be strong.
Kate, this is our chance to beat the bullies. That's the only way we can win against them.
Can we really, Max? I don't believe in miracles anymore either.
Now I do. You're part of the reason why. If you come down with me, I can tell you more.
You're such a good person.
You're gonna slip on, Joe.
Even if you're full of crap. But I'll come with you. You're my friend.
Forever. Can we hug on it?
What?
No! Nobody cares about me! Nobody!
Kate, I saw that card from your father.
Yes, yes. Daddy loves you.
He really loves you without question.
Dad does care, even though I hurt him.
Trust in him. Please, take my hand. I'll save you. Bitch, I'm Rick James. Such a good liar.
I'm sorry. Sorry.
What are you talking about? You saved me from talking in class.
So awesome. Now, I think that's it, guys. I think I've done episode 2, so let's see what happens and how it plays out.
Of course, you're quite a hero for getting Kate to come down, Max.
I didn't do much.
She's modest. Like a real hero.
Yeah, real hero.
As principal of Blackwell Academy, I take my duties seriously. I take the well-being of every student more seriously. What happened today should never happen in a hall of wisdom and knowledge. Mr. Madsen, as our head of security here, those roof doors should always be locked. That's just standard operating procedure. They were not, and that is indeed your responsibility. Mr. Jefferson, I know you can't be expected to know what your students are going through, but Kate has assisted you in class, so you should have known something was amiss. Mr. Prescott, since you are responsible for the Vortex Club parties, and since Miss Marsh did attend your last party, you'll have to answer some more questions. Miss Caulfield, why exactly were you on the roof with Kate Marsh? Did she tell you her plan, or anything at all? Please. Tell us everything.
Oh my god, I fucking hate this game. Oh my god, if only you guys could see my face right now. Rubbing my temple. Who should I rat on? Jefferson? Well, I won't rat on Jefferson because I expect him more. Because he seems pretty cool. Nathan. Rat on Nathan, but see Nathan. I don't want to be Nathan. Oh my god.
Mr. Madsen was bullying Kate.
Oh, grow up.
Excuse me, I was there. I saw you getting in her face.
You have no idea what you saw. Kate Marsh was involved with a bad crowd. I was trying to find out who.
Kate had a double.
You're a pussy.
I was super shocked when I found out.
No, you were part of the crowd. And like I said, I personally saw David physically harass Kate Marsh.
You lying little.
Shh.
Are you going to take this junkie's word over your security officer? I know she smokes and deals marijuana.
That has nothing to do with Kate.
Max, I'm afraid this won't be solved here without proof and a thorough investigation. Now,
yes, I
do you have anything else to say?
Excuse me. I think Max and Nathan need a break before we grill them further. A friend and student just tried to kill herself. They don't need this forum right now.
Yes, I'm kind of devastated right now.
What?
I'd like to be with my family.
All right, Miss Caulfield, please sign here to confirm what you've told us. I'll continue this investigation.
My head is killing me, but I think I can use my power again. All
right, Earwolf. Anong Omega Raspon? Nathan.
All I know is that Kate was at a party and Nathan dosed her. She got wasted and kissed some boys on a viral video without a clue.
I dosed her? Without a clue. Have you seen the video? Whatever. Kate was loaded and playing the field.
You told Kate you took her to the emergency room.
I said I was going to take her to the ER. She sobered up eventually.
Bullshit! Something happened to her and you know it. How about we talk about you waving a gun in the girl's bathroom?
That's total slander. I could sue you and this school so fast. I already have a personal lawyer.
Wait, Max. You told me that nothing...
What?
Are you just making things up? How can I trust
you? What?
You can't. She's smoking.
And that has nothing to do with Kate Marsh.
I'll have to investigate to see if this accusation is true. Therefore, Max,
what?
I'm obliged to contact your parents and suspend you for a few days.
Excuse me. I think Max and...
Please sign here.
Sus. Yo, fuck it. Right thing, dude.
Well, I think we know less now than when we started. We'll be assisting the police with further inquiries. I know this has been a stressful day. I wish
Shia,
I had the power to
you
change
were wrong.
It all for the better.
Shouldn't have done
so
it.
So thank you for coming in.
My stress, my grief. What that father?
I couldn't even believe it was happening. It was literally slow motion as I grabbed her hand. And then I could feel her grabbing mine.
Max, that was the greatest thing I've ever seen. Ever! You reached out, she reached out, hugs, tears, applause, like a superhero.
Not quite. Look at me. I'm a mess.
You're glowing. Seriously, a human halo. I'm pretty sure you earned your wings today.
I'm still worried about Kate. She did try to kill herself. All over a video.
Viral is the right word. Like a disease.
So you watched it.
Just
bad
one.
Bad boy.
And a half time.
Bad boy.
Warren, I don't mean to sound weird, but there's something ominous going on at Blackwell.
Today proves that.
And I'm working on proof that Kate Marsh is connected to Rachel Amber. Somehow. Along with Nathan and Mr. Madsen.
I'm not a big conspiracy guy, but I wouldn't doubt it. Nathan did scare me yesterday, and Madsen is a straight-up dickhead. So, what do you think is really happening?
What the hell is this? The weather confirms this weird day. I feel that chill.
Max, there was no eclipse scheduled today. I would know. I would.
I believe you, Warren. I believe anything this week. I don't have to see you right now.
Well, there you have it, guys. Today was a very strange day in the world of Life is Strange. Life really is strange, so don't forget to leave a comment. I get this nigga getting his dick sucked. Oh my god. Yo, these niggas are coercing. Alright, yeah, so what I want you guys to do is leave a comment down below on what you think we should have done. Probably what we will do next time is live stream as we play. So don't forget to subscribe to us on Twitter so you can get more information on that. That's at Squad TV. Don't forget to subscribe and share our videos. Your support means a lot to us. And stay tuned for the next set of videos we'll have. Yeah, see you around, guys.